Hello, my name is Dima Svetlana and I am student of Privosky Research Medical University. I am going to tell you about machine learning in primary and secondary prevention in cardiology. According to WHO data, in economically developed countries, cardiovascular disease are the leading cause of death. Hypertrophic cardiomyopathy is one of the causes of sudden cardiac death even between young people. Machine learning is becoming an important component of clinical medicine, particularly in risk assessment. Compared to classical risk assessing methods that use just a few clinical variables, machine learning takes into consideration a significantly wider range of variables. Machine learning is a specialized method that allows you to train computer without resorting to programming. This is similar to the process of teaching an infant who learns to classify objects and events, and also find the relationships between them. Determination of cardiovascular risk is an important task in preventive medicine. On this slide, you can see results of two big studies. With yellow, I marked classical risk factors from SCORE 2 and SCORE 2 OP scale as age, smoking, systolic blood pressure, and cholesterol level. But computer chose some other factors too. For example, the auto prognosis model that you can see on the right part of slide has identified 20 the most important indicators. As you can see, the level of physical activity and blood test results was rated as more important in the development of cardiovascular disease than classical risk factors. Also, in the top 5 risk factors included microalbumin in urine for men and self-reported health rating for women. As an example of secondary prevention, I chose sudden cardiac death risk stratification in patients with hypertrophic cardiomyopathy. In the research, Small and his colleagues developed the new model for risk stratification in patients with hypertrophic cardiomyopathy based on a broad set of methods. It was random forest, boosting trees, support vector machine, and neural networks. Also, they used a lot of clinical, genetics, imaging, and laboratory data. The data reported beta ventricular tachycardia prediction, which may be the cause of sudden cardiac death, with AUC of 0.9. Here you can see model explanation for identification of high-risk patients. You can see that prediction probability of high-risk class are shown in green, and those that decrease it are shown in red. For example, with patients with NYHA class 1 have a reduced risk of death compared to patients with classes 3 and 4. The study from 2021 also selected 4 machine learning approaches death due to sudden cardiac death being one of the outcomes. Data from almost 200 people with hypertrophic cardiomyopathy were analyzed. Researchers used a reference model based on 8 previously established clinical parameters and a machine learning model with more than 20 predictors. The machine learning prediction accuracy was 85% compared to reference model of just 73%. Similar results were demonstrated by other studies. I would like to finish my speech with giving you an idea to think about such problem as we have nowadays. Clinical data embodies also a large amount of laboratory data, the processing of which can be waste. Machine learning is capable of analyzing this data and presenting it in a human decision format, having strong future potential in the analysis of data from different sources and risk modeling. Yes, I give you it as an idea of solution of our problem, but obviously we have limitation as an absence of unified standardized programs for analyzing. As you can understand, it's a very important problem nowadays because in different research they use different methods and get different results. Thank you for your attention.